LaSalle from the field.
So in other words, they're not shooting well at all from either the field or the free throw line.
They definitely give you the numbers on that. In the meantime, one point finding Al Husseini from 16, and he knocks it down.
That's that spot. He was begging for that pass, clapping emphatically for him to get that ball.
And nobody was in front of him, or at least a little short one.
There you go, short one.
Castro tries a three. He has really struggled. And then Montfort slows it down with a minute and loose change left. Maracoso. Looking at their options, Salamat inside again with the elbow, that's short, but Montfort coming away with a rebound, loses it to J.D. Castro. Gives it up to Cholo, mid-range jumper, rattles out,
boom! Two white shirts going at it for the rebound, Inaka Amuyan, Mishko, Simon Atkins, battling it out for that offensive rebound that should have been theirs.
44 seconds remaining here in the first quarter, and Ateneo holding on to a three-point lead. Maracoso sets up Al Husseini with a fake. Montfort, top of the circle, is short, and he dribbles out his
goal. Wow. Miss. The third offensive rebound of Montfort already, even though the other one who rebounded it and lost it. But still, the hustle is there, being shown by the guards of Ateneo.
Maracoso for three. Montfort tapping it. Atkins with 20 seconds in our game clock. Goes to his left. Wild on the play.
Oh,
but picked up by P.J. Walsham.
No charge called. Atkins ran right through Maracoso, who was set up there for quite a time.
5 seconds remaining in the first quarter. It is a slim one-point lead. Back here at the Araneta Coliseum for more of the UAP on Studio 23. Watching us all over the world, TJ, we are live all over the TFC, the Filipino Channel 2. So, lahat ng Pilipinong nanonood, mabuhay kayo. Salamat sa inyong panonood. TJ, some numbers for the first quarter. Very low scoring at 13-12.
Very low scoring ball game in the first quarter. Shot made by Eric Salamat on the run, and he gets the foul, and he'll go to the line. But looking at field goal percentages, Ateneo was pretty bad at 31%, but even worse is Nasal at 19%. Folks, Nasal was 5 out of 26.
Wow.
From the floor.
Eric Salamat, tough is the operative word for this guy. You said this guy comes in with a lot of impact, and this is why he is admired and loved by the Ateneo community. It's that toughness that he brings off the bench and the impact that he creates for the team.
And interestingly, Salamat didn't have much of an impact with Ateneo in the first round.
Yes.
It was really only the second round win that they had, but he had some really crucial games.
Remember, it is the second round that they had a 5-game winning streak.
Right.
Broken only by a team that had nothing to play for but pride.
If I remember,
National University.
After they had that 10-day because of the delay with the storm in the schedule, that's when Salama had a little bit more playing time, and Ken Baracoso's playing time was limited.
Yeah. That was Rica Paralelo, the news from Ateneo, again, attending this game. All important one, the winner, goes on to take twice to beat advantage. And we know how huge that advantage is.
Yes.
That's an 81% percentage of a team that has twice beat advantage. As you see, Rico Meyer off and hobble back into the court.
That's huge. It looks like he's still limping on it a bit. So I don't know how much he'll still be effective with his, you know, this guy needs his speed and his jumping ability.
His mobility too. Let's see. He looks to be fine, but there, that lift wasn't there.
Yeah. The move was there, but the left definitely was not.
Salamat has Cholo Villanueva in front of him. They send it out to Montfort. 8:30 to play in the first half. No direction on this offensive for Ateneo. Then on their 24, Maracoso has Meyer Hopper on him. Forces that one. Rabah puts it up for the jump hook. Castro comes away with it. Cholo has Walsham on the other side. Cholo sidestep into the hole.
He could have dropped it off to Walsham, streaking on the weak side. But then Cholo, the wind Cholo, he has those tricks up his sleeve, especially in the open court.
He's not the fastest of all guys, as a foul is called by the referee away from Cholo Villanueva. Now again, this is a matter of angles here, DJ.
Yep. That's going to be foul number two for Cholo Villanueva.
So
So quickly, Coach Franz picks up Kishkov on the bench, empty white tank.
Let's look at it from this angle. This is where the other
referee was. Elbow to elbow, there was contact.
Of somebody throwing a coin on the court.
Piso.
It's still rolling.
And the refs see it now.
T.Y. Tang back.
You know, that foul would not have been a foul if Salamat, who is it? Was it Salamat?
I think it was Barcos.
If Barcos was not in the air.
Okay.
It's an off-balance, just an area that has a contact. Pero nakatayo lang yun, and there was that kind of minor contact, normally that would have been called a foul.
8 minutes, so loose change remaining in the first half. Bert Long, James Manas on him. Back to Raba. The high low play doesn't materialize for Ateneo.
Second time, a horrible pass from Raba Alucino.
Panira na rin, TJ.
Also, had a good look also, but he opted not to shoot.
Nobody was in front of it, huh? It is Ateneo La Salle round three, and the crowd has definitely swollen up now. And it is a school day and an office day. They have now made their way to the big goal. Mascaso continues to struggle in this game. He was 1 out of 15 against Ateneo in that last game.
Far away from the ball. But the question is, does he get three free throws?
There.
Okay. Or maybe the foul is called on the rebound, game, not on the release.
Manas, nowhere to go. Unable to adjust. High offer puts up an awkward looking shot.
High offer is not so good. He's hopping, he's favored that right angle. He doesn't look 100% at all.
Guardado has Kishko. They gave him the baseline. The jump hook for four.
Not an easy one. One of his favorite moves, but it was a little bit further out than his comfort zone.
It is 18 to 14. We send it over to Vanamir right now for Ateneo.
After that electric first round, the team was told to get to the basket today. Let's not make the same mistakes as the first round. They're also told to run because jogging is just not going to cut it today. Recognize the defense that they're in and adjust. And also play good defense because it's what'll win us this game. TJ.
Thank you very much. They have forced Masada to a lot of bad shots. Thank you, Vanna, for a Samson courtside update. But Samson is not that hard to imagine. J.V. Casho. Well, we got a feel for this guy. Missing the turnaround in the Ateneo game, the turnaround, the potential game-tying shot. Missing the free throw against the UE. The 1 out of 15 struggles in that round number two encounter. So there's a little bit of talk about J.B. Castro and the pressure that he's in, especially being one of the veterans already of the team.
So I think with J.B. Castro, I mean, we've seen him be successful in the past, but he would do it out of the shadows. He would come out of nowhere.
He's a hero.
But the question is, when his name is on the line, when he's expected to be a hero,
speaking of heroes, will Kirk Long come on today for Ateneo? He already has 7 points on the pull-up and a four-point lead with under 7 minutes remaining here in the first half. It is Manas who is able to put it up and in.
Manas, who normally starts for Coach Frank Kumano, coming off the bench today, seems to be very comfortable with his role here, and he has a tough task and trying to check Kirk Long. And another foul here by La Salle, in almost in the backcourt. That's how much pressure they're putting on the ball carriers of Ateneo. And the question may be too much pressure. Fouls might speak for themselves.
Now speaking of La Salle, let's throw it over to Sharon Yu for DLSU.
Boom, coach told the team that we need to get those rebounds. The blue team did better on the defensive rebounds during the first quarter, 10-7. Coach also gave Kish a pat on the back for his good hustle. And something to cheer about, Rigo's back with his great ankle but three games. And oh, Boom, you may notice, number 15 on their jersey. That's Ryan's jersey number. He surely missed him. Over to you, Kish.
Well, we already talked about the fact that...